Hello students, how are you? Hope you're doing well today. Okay, so in last session I told you about dimensions for you, right? What is dimension and how we are going to write the dimensional formula, right? So in this session I'm going to continue with the same dimensional formulas. Okay, we'll tell you how we have to write the dimensional formulas for different derived physical quantities we have. See, here I have written number of physical quantities and their formulas. Okay, so nanu nimage ninne kuda helide, it is very easy to write the dimensional formula, but only the thing is you should have to remember the formula of a particular physical quantity. So nimige ondu particular physical quantity gottidre, aa quantity na formula gottidre, it will be easy for you to write the dimensions. Clear? Okay, see here I have written a physical quantity called momentum. So how we are going to define momentum? So momentum can be defined as mass and velocity. So it can be defined as the product of mass and velocity, and the formula for the momentum is mass into velocity. Okay, so now if I know the formula of momentum, I can easily write the dimensions of momentum here. So mass have a dimension m, right, and velocity has the dimension lt minus 1. So yesterday we have derived the dimensional formula for velocity, so I know the dimensional formula of velocity, so directly I am writing the dimensional formula of velocity here, that is lt minus 1. Along with this I am having mass, so I am writing m rise to 1, l rise to 1, t rise to minus 1. So this is the dimensional formula of momentum. Clear? Okay, either you can read this as mlt minus 1, or you can read this as m rise to 1, l rise to 1, t rise to minus 1. Okay, okay, so let me come to the second physical quantity what I have written here, that is torque, torque, torque. Okay, so this torque can be defined as the product of force and distance. So it has a formula, force into distance. Okay, so yesterday also we have derived the dimensional formula for force, that is mlt minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula of force. Along with the force I'm having distance here, so distance is nothing but length, so length have a dimensional formula, that is capital L. So here I'm having 1l, l into l, l square. So here we'll write directly the dimensional formula of torque as ml square t minus 2. Okay, okay, so now I'm having coefficient of elasticity here. Okay, how we are going to define coefficient of elasticity? So it can be defined by the ratio stress and strain. Okay, so stress by strain will give you the coefficient of elasticity. So yesterday also we have derived the dimensional formula for stress. So stress can be defined as the ratio of force and area. Force by area will give you stress, and strain doesn't have any direction, so it doesn't have any dimensions. I told you yesterday, because strain is nothing but it is the change in length divided by original length. So erdu kuda length irodrinda, so it will get l rise to 0. You'll get l rise to 0 for strain, so it doesn't have any dimension. So here you only have to write the dimensions of stress. Okay, so I'm going to write directly the dimensions of stress here. So for force it is mlt minus 2, and for this area
n square.
So if I write the dimensions of stress, we'll write m l divided by h square. If you take l square to the numerator, it becomes l raised to minus 2, l raised to minus 2, l raised to 1 is l raised to minus 1, and here t raised to minus 2.
Okay, MLT minus 2. So, ನಿಮಗೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಏರಿಯಾ. ಫಾರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಟಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಟು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿನಾಮಿನೇಟರ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂಮರೇಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 1 ಟಿ ಮೈನಸ್ 2. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಸಿಟಿ, ಕೋಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಾಸ್ಟಿಸಿಟಿ. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಓಕೆ, let's move on to another physical quantity I have, that is surface tension. So what is the formula of surface tension? Formula of surface tension I have written here, that is force divided by length. Okay, so here also we'll write the dimensional formula of force first, and then we'll divide this by length, we'll write the dimensional formula of length, and finally we'll rearrange this to get the dimensional formula of surface tension. Okay, fine.
So here force, for force we'll write MLT minus 2, and for length we'll write the dimension L, because length is having a dimension L. So therefore the final dimensional formula for surface tension is, see here, L, L gets cancelled. So finally you'll get MT minus 2. So MT minus 2 is the dimensional formula of surface tension.
Hope you understood, okay? And next, let's move on to another physical quantity we have, that is surface energy. So surface energy, how are you going to define surface energy? So surface energy can be defined as the ratio of work to area. So work divided by area will give you surface energy. So here we'll write the dimensional formula of work directly, then I will write the dimensional formula of area. So then we'll rearrange this to get the dimensional formula of surface energy. Okay, so here the dimensional formula for work. So why I'm writing this directly? Because I have already written, because I have already told you the dimensional formula of these things, right? Okay, so ml square t minus 2 is the dimensional formula. So it is not difficult to write the dimensional formula. Only by practicing you can able to write the dimensional formula of all the physical quantities. But only the thing is, you should have to learn, you should have to remember, you should have to by heart the formulas of a particular physical quantity. If you by heart the physical quantity, if you by heart the formulas of a physical quantity, then it will be easy for you to write the dimensions of a given physical quantity you have. Clear? Okay, hope you're understanding what I'm telling to you. So work divided by area. So area is having a dimensional formula L square. So L square gets cancelled. Again, you'll get the same dimensional formula for surface energy as you have for surface tension. So here the dimensional formula for surface energy is MT minus 2. Okay, look here, for surface tension you are getting the same dimensional formula, for surface energy also we are getting the same dimensional formula itself. Clear? Okay, so now let's move on to another physical quantity we have, that is coefficient of viscosity. So what is the formula of coefficient of viscosity? So why I am telling these things? Because you are going to study all these formulas as well as all these physical quantities about pressure gradient, specific heat, latent heat, entropy, radius of variation in your PU1. Okay, so you should know how to write the dimensional formula, and you should know what is the particular formula for a physical quantity. So I am telling all these things to you. Okay, and in examination also they are going to ask any one of the dimensional formula. Okay, so coefficient of viscosity, so it has a formula, force into distance divided by
area into velocity. Force into distance divided by area into velocity. If you know this formula, then you can easily write the dimensions of coefficient of viscosity. Okay, so for force, let me write the dimensional formula for force. So here I'm writing, so for force, the dimensional formula of force is MLT minus 2. Okay, and the dimensional formula of distance is L. And the dimensional formula for area is L square, because area can be defined as length into breadth. And velocity is having the dimensional formula LT minus 1. Clear? So therefore, the final dimensional formula, here only have to rearrange. So L gets cancelled and this L square goes to the numerator. T raised to minus 1 goes to the numerator. So first let me take all the denominator value to the numerator and we'll see what will be the final dimensional formula here. So MLT minus 2, and we'll take this L square to the numerator, so it becomes L raised to minus 2, and T raised to minus 1, it becomes T raised to plus 1. So the final dimensional formula, see, L raised to 1, L raised to minus 2 is L raised to minus 1. L raised to minus 1. And here you are having T raised to minus 2 and T raised to plus 1. So T raised to minus 1. So this is the final dimensional formula of coefficient of viscosity, ML minus 1, T minus 1. Or you can read this as M raised to 1, L raised to minus 1 and T raised to minus 1. Clear? Okay, let's move on to another physical quantity I have, that is angle. How we are going to define angle here? Angle is nothing but arc of a length divided by radius. Suppose let me consider a circle here which is having a center O. So if I join a line from center to any point on the circle, okay, it will give me the radius. Right? Similarly, if I join another point from the circle to any point on the circle, it will also give me the radius. Okay? So this is the arc of a length. This is what we call arc, which is length. Okay? Which is nothing but distance here. Arc. Arc. Okay, length. And radius is also represents what? Length here. So therefore, arc of a length divided by radius will give you angle. Clear? So here, arc of a length is represented by L, radius is represented by L. So that is, dimensional formula for arc of length is L here, and the dimensional formula for radius is also L. So finally, L raised to 1 minus 1, that is L raised to 0. So angle doesn't have any dimension, because anything to the power 0 will give you the value 1. So here we'll write the dimensional formula for angle is M raised to 0, L raised to 0 and T raised to 0. M 0, L 0, T 0. So this is the dimensional formula of angle. Clear? Okay then, so now let's move on to another physical quantity I have, that is moment of inertia. So how we are going to define moment of inertia? So I have a formula, I have already written the dimensional formula for moment of inertia here, that is mass into distance square. Okay, mass into distance square. So this is the formula for moment of inertia. So I can easily write the dimensional formula of mass and the dimensional formula of distance, but I have to do square, so we'll do the square here. So let's see, for mass we'll write the dimensional formula, that is m, and for distance square we'll write the dimensional formula, that is L square. So therefore, the final dimensional formula is ML square T rise to 0. Or you can read that as M rise to 1, L rise to 2, T rise to 0. Or simply ML square. So that is the dimensional formula of moment of inertia. Okay. And coming to the next physical quantity I have, that is radius of gyration. So radius of gyration. Gyration is nothing but distance. Okay. Radius of gyration is nothing but distance between two points. Okay. Later on you are going to study about these things. So radius of gyration. So what is radius of gyration? Radius of gyration is nothing but distance. So here the dimensional formula for radius of gyration is L, or I can read this as M rise to 0, L T rise to 0. So this is the dimensional formula for radius of gyration. Okay. And next move on to velocity gradient. Velocity gradient. Nodi gradient L barutto. A particular term distance in the divide agirutte aita gradient anta helthege velocity gradient anta helthege velocity divided by distance adhe tara pressure gradient anta helidre pressure divided by distance gradient el barutho so we have to divide that particular quantity by distance. Okay, so velocity gradient. So here velocity gradient has a formula, velocity divided by distance. So first I have to write the dimensional formula of velocity, then I have to write the dimensional formula of distance, and then we'll rearrange to get the final dimensional formula for velocity gradient. Okay, so let me write the dimensional formula of velocity here. So dimensional formula for velocity is L T minus 1 divided by distance is just an L. So therefore L L gets cancelled, and we'll write this dimensional formula as M rise to 0, L rise to 0, T rise to minus 1. So this is the dimensional formula for velocity gradient. Clear? Okay, next I'm having pressure gradient here. So again, for pressure, we have to divide this pressure by distance because we are finding the pressure gradient. Okay, so how we are going to write the formula for pressure? So pressure is nothing but force divided by area, right? So yesterday we were discussed about pressure, and we wrote the dimensional formula for pressure also. So for pressure we are having this formula, force by area and divided by distance. So for distance, okay, it is distance. So we'll write this as F divided by A into distance. Okay, so therefore this can be written as, okay, so here we'll write the dimensional formula. So I'm not having much space here to write the dimensional formula of pressure gradient. So first we'll solve the dimensional formula, okay, and the final formula we'll write here. So what is the dimensional formula of force? That is MLT minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula of force. And what is the dimensional formula of area? That is L square. And the dimensional formula of distance is just L, right? So therefore L gets cancelled, and L goes to, L square goes to the numerator, so it becomes M L rise to minus 2 T rise to minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula of pressure. So directly I'm going to write the dimensional formula of pressure gradient here. That is M L rise to minus 2 T rise to minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula of pressure gradient. Okay, let's move on to another physical quantity we have, that is specific heat. So specific heat, how we are going to define specific heat, and what is the formula for specific heat? So formula for specific heat is heat divided by mass into temperature.
See, heat divided by mass into temperature will give specific heat. So heat is nothing but the energy stored inside a container. Okay, so heat is equivalent to energy here. So we'll write the dimensional formula for energy for heat here. Okay, dimensional formula of energy for heat. So the dimensional formula is ml square T minus 2 divided by, and for mass, dimensional formula is m, and for temperature, dimensional formula. How we are going to write the dimensional formula for temperature? For time, we use capital T, right? And for temperature, either you can use theta or you can use K here. So let me consider K here. Let me write K for temperature. Okay, because we are going to measure the temperature in terms of Kelvin, and the symbol for Kelvin is K. So I am writing K here. So m gets cancelled. Therefore, the final dimensional formula would be m rise to 0 L square T rise to minus 2 K rise to minus 1. So this is the dimensional formula for specific heat. Clear? Okay, so let's move on to latent heat. So latent heat has the formula heat by mass. Heat by mass. So therefore, for heat, again I'm going to write the dimensional formula for energy. So that is m l square t minus 2 divided by m. So m gets cancelled, and the dimensional formula would be m rise to 0 l square t rise to minus 2. So this is the dimensional formula for latent heat. And for entropy has the formula heat divided by temperature. So we are dividing heat with the temperature. So for heat, again you have to write, see, the dimensional formula for work, energy and heat are same. That is ml square T minus 2. Okay, divided by temperature is represented with capital K. So therefore, the dimensional formula for entropy is ml square T minus 2 K rise to minus 1, because I am taking that K to the numerator. Okay. So these are the dimensions of physical quantities we have. Hope this is not difficult for you. It is very much easy. I told you, only the thing is you have to remember the formulas of a particular physical quantities. Then only you can be able to write the dimensional formula. Then only you can be able to write the dimensions of particular physical quantity. Okay? This is very much easy, and you should have to learn, because this is very much important for your examination point of view also, as well as for your higher studies. Okay, I am going to end this session here. Okay, take care all of you. Bye.